Live music on BBC Radio 1.
I'm delighted to say that we have Clairo on the show tonight providing the live music. Clairo, how are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm really well. Happy New Year to you.
You too.
I was having a little snoop on your Instagram and I saw that you called 2019 the best year of your life.
I did.
Yeah. I mean, wow, that's incredible. How are you feeling about 2020 so far? I know only a few weeks in.
2020 is great. It's like, you know, it feels like a nice transition from 2019. I think 2019 was like the busiest and craziest year of my life. And there were so many crazy ups and downs that I could have never prepared for. So I feel like 2020 has been pretty calm.
Which
also feels really good.
yeah, absolutely. Yeah, sometimes a roller coaster is, you need to be able to climb off the roller coaster and just coast for a while.
Right.
Stay sane. Hey, we were really happy to get to speak to you tonight because this gig that we're about to hear, you recorded for us back in December, so the 3rd of December. And we were unable to speak to you because you were ill of health. So first of all, we're glad that you're better.
I'm so happy I'm not sick anymore. That was like, it was the worst. It's so hard to tour when you can barely speak, but you got to make it work.
Yeah. Well, you got the songs down, so that's the hardest bit. And now we get to talk about them. So we're gonna start with a track. We're gonna play Softly, which we've been loving playing on the show, the album version over the last few months. But before we do, for those who haven't seen you live, tell us what the setup was down at Maida Vale when you were there.
The setup is basically, I have a band of three other people, and they're like some of my greatest friends in the world. I met them through my management, but the moment that we started to work together, it was like a perfect match. So I have my guitarist Haley, my bassist Dejan, and my drummer Eddie, and then I go on and off guitar as well. But it's kind of just, I wanted a setup that felt like a real band, and I think it works really well for me.
Okay. Well, let's hear Softly then from the album Immunity. This is Clairo and her band at BBC Maida Vale Studios.
Am
Okay, that was Softly. Clairo is here with us on the show tonight. I was thinking about what you said about your band. I mean, how incredibly serendipitous is that, that you kind of met them through your management and they were all perfect?
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. I think we talk about it a lot. We're very lucky to have such a great group of people, you know, in my corner. I think that was something I always really wanted to have. I always really wanted to be in a band in general. I think, like, sometimes I wish Clairo was like a legit band, but it's so fun to be able to work with other people and have other people's opinions be let in towards like live arrangements and helping me figure out what's best for me.
Yeah.
Realizing that I also don't know everything.
Yeah.
By myself, so.
Where are you right now? I can hear airplanes.
I'm in Los Angeles. I'm trying to run away from the planes.
Every time we speak to you, I feel so bad because you're like running away from noise. Where was it last time? You were in Canada or something?
Last time, we were in Canada or Oregon or something. I ran up like 6 flights of stairs.
Yeah, you were on the street and then you finally just had to go into the venue that you were playing at and you had to hustle your way in because the security guard didn't know you. You're like, I'm playing here tonight.
They didn't think that I should be let in.
Let's hear another track then, Clairo, please, from your wonderful gig that you've done for us. So next, you are going to play North.
Yes. North is, like, I think my favorite song on the album, if I were to choose. I just love how it makes me feel. I love the energy around it. I think it's about kind of how relationships can become fleeting within touring and how it's actually really hard to maintain any sort of romantic life while you're on the road and all that, you know?
Yeah.
Just tour romances. That's basically the gist of that song. It's a very important song to me. It's my favorite song to play live. It's my favorite song on the album. Yeah.
Okay, that's good enough. Please, let's hear it right now then. So this is Clairo performing that song, North.
Yeah.
There you go. That was North from the legendary Maybell Studios, Clairo and band down there last month performing these songs for us. So 2020, having had 2019, like the busiest year, the breakout year, the debut album release, all these major milestone things, what do you want to, this is such a cheesy question, but I want to know, what do you want to like leave this year having done or having achieved?
I just think I entered this year feeling really inspired. I think last January, I came to Los Angeles to write Immunity, and I'm back here again, January 2020, ready to write more music. And it feels like, it feels really good. I feel like this year is going to be dedicated to writing music and to taking more time on the next project and to really being a little bit, really being deliberate with everything that I want to put out and everything I want to say. I'm just really excited to keep writing. I feel like I'm growing in a lot of ways, and you know, the next step is always the most exciting to me. But yeah, I think just resting and not going too crazy with the touring, but you know, trying to write something that pushes me forward a little bit in terms of like how I view my own music. I think I'm getting closer and closer and closer to my ideal music. I think like Community was my favorite thing I've ever done, and I didn't know I could do anything like that. I didn't know that could be brought out of me. So I can only imagine what working for another year could do for me.
Yeah, I don't absolutely. Know. Will you work with Rostam again, do you think?
I'd love to. I don't know if we'll do another whole project, because Communities was like our heart and soul. But yeah, we're always going to work together. Yeah. It's just inevitable.
Hey, let's talk about this cover version that you've done for us then. So you've covered, you tell me what we've covered, please.
We covered Once a Friend by Diana Gordon.
Okay, and why did you choose this track and this woman?
I was sent this song by my friend not too long ago, maybe like a year ago. And I listened to it for the first time on a plane, and I immediately just burst into tears. It was like, it just felt like the prettiest, most genuine song I'd heard in a really, really long time. It felt like she was covering a classic song. And it hit me in a place where I haven't been hit by music in a long time. And every time I listen to it, it feels so nostalgic, even though I don't have one distinctive memory that's attached to it. I think, like, I view music within memories. Like, when I hear a song, I'm brought back to a certain moment, but there's no specific moment with that song. It's really just a beautiful, nostalgic feeling that makes me really happy every single time.
How was it actually singing it?
It was amazing. It was so fun. It's like I think Haley, my guitarist, was happy because we didn't know what to cover for so long, and I ended up choosing a song that she could play on guitar really easily. So she wasn't that stressed. But it was really great. It felt really good. And listening back, it feels like it was the right choice for me. I should do more stuff like that.
Okay, let's do it. Diana Gordon, Once a Friend, as covered by Clairo.
Bye.